enough on me.
Well, I hope it's still at the movies.
Take Mr. Kelly to the movies sometime, won't you, Jimmy?
Oh, I'd have got enough if it hadn't been for that sore knee of mine.
Oh, well, if you've got a sore knee, you can't dance. What do you think of a man who asked a girl to go dancing and then has a sore knee? Does your mother let you associate with people like that?
She died last week.
Oh, Jim. I'm sorry. I wouldn't have...
That's all right.
Attaboy, Jimmy. The old chin up all the time.
Mom would have liked you. Mr. Kelly, too.
Jimmy. Yes. I want you to promise me something.
Yes, ma'am.
Anytime you feel lonesome, will you come and see me?
Could I?
Anytime you want.
Sure, thanks. I sure will.
Hey, Jim. When you get through cutting me out with my girl, how about going back to your aunt and uncle?
Hello?
Oh? I can't understand you.
Oh, guess it's for you.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. I called up to tell you I've got everything under control. Everything is exactly as if it were right here. Right here.
What? Hello. Say, what's the matter with you? Hello. Hello.
Sorry, baby. That was important. I'll be back as soon as I can. If I can't make it, why? I'll phone.
Never mind. I'll know if you're coming.
Yeah, how do you know?
I'll call up that fortune teller.
Oh. All right. So long, darling.
Say, guess I better be going too. Just thought of something. It's getting late. Well, good night.
Good night, Jimmy. Remember to come and see me again.
Well, good night. I had a very good time.
Hello. Why don't you answer, Kelly? What's the matter?
At it again, huh? Well, you're through. Get out.
Oh, Kelly, you wouldn't talk to an old pal that way.
Get out!
For you, Mr. Kelly.
Yeah, you would. You'll be here the first thing in the morning. Hey, it's getting kind of late. You better run along, haven't you?
Thanks, Mr. Kelly. Good night.
So long. Oh. Yeah. Oh, three quarts of wine? Okay, bring them right over. Yeah.
Of course, it's none of my business, but I'm sure they are bootleggers. Well, I I've done my duty, and I expect you to do yours.
Hi, Commissioner.
Hello, kid.
Now listen, Jimmy, this is what I want you to do. You see, I've been out of this place all day long. All I want you to do is answer the phone. Somebody calls, tell them I'm out, get their number. You can do that?
Sure I can.
Here's another thing. I do all my business over that phone. That door is supposed to stay locked all the time. And then if you don't know who owns the place, you don't know where you live, because I live there too, you don't even know my name.
Yes, but why, Mr. Kelly?
Well, you see, Jimmy, it's like this. I got a lot of big connections. You know that, don't you?
Yes, sir.
Well, you see, a man in my position, he's liable to have a lot of enemies. You never know what they might try to do.
Sure.
So if anything goes wrong, no matter what it is, you get in touch with me on the quiet. But be sure it's on the quiet. And you don't know me at all.
Oh, I get it.
That's the stuff. Remember, Jimmy, Kelly's your friend. A guy that'll always stand behind you.
And I'll do the same for you, too.
K.O., Jimmy. K.O. Now, shove it off. Oh, and Jimmy.
Yes, sir?
Get a load of this. I'm paying you $25 a week.
Whoopee!
You've been here before? So you're taking it pretty easy for a first-timer.
Nothing's gonna happen to me.
What do you mean, nothing's gonna happen? It's happening.
Yeah, but I got a friend with connections. And he'll walk in here any minute.
Come this way.
Mason. James Mason.
Say, that friend of yours better get his connections working.
How old are you, James?
15. Almost.
Ever been in trouble before?
No, sir.
Where do you live?
No place in particular.
Parents dead?
Yes, sir.
Haven't you any relatives in this town? Someone that we ought to notify about this?
No, sir. No relatives anywhere.
Now, James, obviously you wouldn't have found yourself in this trouble if you hadn't been led astray by someone older and more responsible, would you? Would you? We want to give you every chance to cooperate with us. Now, it isn't you, but the man who hired you that we want. And your failure to expose him is really a more serious offense than the other charges against you. Now, come. Who was it?
Nobody.
Very well, then.
You leave me no alternative. I'm sorry I have to do this, but you'll spend the next 3 years at the State Industrial School for Boys.
You want to come out and give him a speech?
Oh, I suppose so. How many of them are there?
11, and two repeaters.
Two repeaters. Always the repeaters.
James Mason?
Yes, sir.
13144.